And now our continuing series on the greatest artist of all time. At number 25, Fats Domino. In 2004, in the Rolling Stone magazine, Dr. John wrote, "After John Lennon and Paul McCartney, Fats Domino and his partner, Dave Bartholomew, were probably the greatest team of songwriters ever. They always had a simple melody, a hip set of chord changes, and a cool groove. And their songs all had simple lyrics. That's the key. There are no deep plots in Fats Domino's songs." Even when Fats Domino did songs by somebody else, it was still Fats. He could really lock in with his band and play those hard-driving boogie shuffles. It was pre-funk stuff, and it was New Orleans. And he did it all his way. One thing that most people miss, which he did on some of the biggest records like Blueberry Hill, he could do piano rolls with both hands. I give a lot of credit to Dave Bartholomew, Fats' producer and songwriting partner. They were a team. Dave produced records perfect for Fats. He had the sense to go with the best feeling take when they were recording. People would have missed something great about Fats if they had just heard the more correct takes, the ones without that extra off-the-wall thing that Fats could bring. You can't hardly hear the bass on some of Fats' early records. Later, they started doubling the bass line with a guitar, and it made for a very distinctive sound that became standard with Phil Spector. I don't know if Phil picked it up from Fats or from somebody who picked it up from Fats, but it all started with Fats. You can hear a lot of Fats in Jerry Lee Lewis. Anytime anybody plays a slow blues, the piano player will eventually get to something like Fats. I can't tell you the number of times I played sessions and was asked specifically to do Fats. 80 kajillion little bands all through the South. We all had to play Fats Domino songs. Everybody. Everywhere. Fats is old school to the max. He loved to work the house, do long shows, and push the piano across the stage with his belly. That innocence is there in his music. He's a good man, and people respond to that goodness. I don't think it was about anything other than the tradition of working the house and what felt good to Fats. Dr. John concludes, "When all the payola scandals were happening and it looked bad for rock and roll, Fats did an interview in some magazine. He said, 'I don't know what all the trouble is about us being a bad influence on teenagers. I'm just playing the same music I played all my life.' And that's what Fats was about. He didn't look on what he did as special or different. He just did what Fats did." Antoine Domino Jr., born February 26, 1928, in New Orleans, Louisiana. He had 5 gold records before 1955, and over his career, 35 top 40 hits. Our song for today is from his 1957 album, Here Stands Fats Domino. It's I'm Walkin'. It was Fats' 3rd release in a row to reach number 1 on the R&B bestsellers chart. It stayed there for 6 weeks. It also continued Fats' crossover appeal. It peaked at number 4 on the pop singles chart. It's our continuing series on the greatest artist of all time. And at number 25, Fats Domino.
I'm walking, hear the need, I'm talking. Find you and me, I'm hoping that you come back to me. I'm lonely as I can be. I'm waiting for your company. I'm hoping that you come back to me. What you gonna do when the well run dry? You gonna run away and hide? I'm gonna run right by your side. For you, pretty baby, I even die. I'm walking, yes indeed, I'm talking. But you and me, I'm hoping that you come back to me.
all you're gonna do is dry your eye on walking. Here's the deal I'm talking, by you and me, I'm hoping that you come back to me. Thank you.